Whoa. It is witch's tit cold outside. Alright. Eppin' freezing. How you guys doing? Hope you guys are staying warm. My last video I mentioned I got a new job. One of the things I didn't tell you is that this job starts at midnight, 1 a.m. in the morning. So the coldest part of the day is when I am working. But it's okay. I'm not bitching. Received something in the mail today that I wasn't quite sure if I was ever going to see. And it's not an issue of, well, oh, I can't believe, you know, I didn't get this. This is from a gentleman who last time I saw a video of his, things weren't looking that great. This is from 0818SemperFi, Roger. I truly, sincerely hope that things have turned around for you. I know you said you were starting a new business, or you had started a new business, and it wasn't doing as you anticipated, and I sure as shit hope that it has turned around for you and things are looking brighter and everything's positive. And the irony of this is the timing, if you will. For those of you who do not know, 0818SemperFi, Roger is a Seahawks fan. So, everybody knows if you can look by the name on my username, I do live in Denver and I am a Broncos fan. So, I don't know if he planned this, but this just makes the weather outside sting a little bit more. Here we go. Oh, we have a note. One of these. It's been a while since you guys have seen one of these. Oh my goodness. I won't even look at it, but let's look at the note. There's a bunch of stop signs on here. All right. Brett, first of all, I want to let you know how honored I am to be selected to represent the Seahawks in your PC. Second, as you have figured out by now, when you sent me the helmet, I knew we had a good team and we had a chance at the Super Bowl. And if that happened, I wanted that on the helmet. It did! Exclamation point, exclamation point, exclamation point. The cards that you sent were unreal, man. Words will never explain what that meant to me. In closing, I will not be breaching the contract due to my financial situation, which is good because that will lead me into my next topic. But there is a little something different inside. Hope you like it. It's the abstract and the obscure that I'm really a big fan of. Cards are nice, but the abstract, the difference, is what really, is what's really cool. P.S. Sorry your team had to take such a smackdown. There's nothing to apologize for, man. Like, the Seahawks did exactly what the hell they said they were going to do. Take care. Roger Sodders. Semper Fi! We got a little autograph here and a Seahawks Super Bowl champions. Yes, I will be the first to admit that halfway through the game, I think I flipped channels and watched the Kitten Bowl because it was more exciting than what I was watching on TV. So, here we go. All right. And he returned the Sharpie. Let's see what we got happening here. Alright. I'm always so excited to get these and see what people write. On the opposite side of the spectrum, I sent Steve Broncos79 a Broncos mini helmet to sign. He said that he was going to wait for when the Broncos won the Super Bowl to put that on his helmet. And then he sent me a text message that says, well, everything I wanted to put on this helmet, I'm now going to have to not put it on there. And it's going to be completely different than what I had hoped for. I was like, dude, it's okay, man. All right, so I'll pull this out. Let's see what we got here. All right. Here we go. We got Roger's autograph right there, 0818SemperFi. We got 12th Man Strong up there at the top. It's a beast mode. Super Bowl 48 champs. It's a little bit rubbing in my face. It's okay. All gave some gave all. Lost but never forgotten, Semper Fidelis. That right there is really cool, man. Like that, that's really awesome. I mean, the things you guys come up with to put on helmets is better than any piece of cardboard I could ever stumble upon on the bay or on check out my cock. That is awesome, Roger. Thank you very much. And if that weren't enough, I sent him a couple Steve Largen cards, and I got here a Legendary Contenders insert. This looks like to be from 2011 Contenders. Steve Largent. Always love me some Steve Largent. So, thank you very much, Roger. That is awesome that we'll be joining the rest of the YouTube Hall of Fame up here. I still haven't figured out how to properly display that. I will. But, before I go, I just want to touch down on one of the things that, I've watched on YouTube lately. James Fight on 5-2 had posted a kind of opinion video, not a contest, an opinion of what you should do with gifts or just becauses, as they have come to know to be known. How we should handle them. Should you feel obligated to keep that, even if you don't PC that player or that team anymore? Should you feel guilty if you do move it, if you sell it? Should you let the person who sent you that gift know of your intentions? Whether it may be, and here's where I stand. I'm going to give a little bit of a different perspective, because I think we all feel what everybody has already said. I mean, I watched a couple of videos. I mean, Brad's video, Brad8671, pretty much said everything I would have said too. So I don't want to sit here and regurgitate that for you, but from a different perspective, coming strictly as the set hunter, if you are working on sets and I send you a card that is not necessarily a card for your set, it's just, you know, hey, you know, James, I send you a Bo Jackson autograph. You will, let's say you already have that autograph card, but you're all, at the same time you're working on a set, and a card for this for your set pops up, and let's say you don't have the finances or the money to obtain said set card. By all means, man, use the card I sent you to obtain the card you need for your set. Like, that's how I feel. I mean, people might not feel the same way as I do, but for me personally, if I send you something and a set card pops up that you need, I would be upset if you didn't move the card I sent you to obtain that set card, because I know how frustrating and time-consuming it takes to put sets together. And when you reach certain points, like I have in my set, where you're so close, and when new cards pop up, it's once every 3 or 4 months. You know, that feeling you get that when you see a new card, you're like, oh my god. You start going through your stuff saying, okay, what can I move in order to obtain that? So, I don't know. I feel once a card transfers ownership to a new party, then you are releasing all responsibility to that card. If I send you a card and you turn around and sell it to obtain something you want, by all means, you are not going to hurt my feelings. And it's the thought that counts. Just like Brad said, just like any of you guys will say or feel. It's the thought that counts more. And this is one of the things I did. That's one of the reasons why I started doing this, is because I'm the only person I know who thinks that these are priceless. And the guy down the street will probably look at these and be like, why do you have a bunch of mini helmets signed by a bunch of random people on YouTube? They'll never understand that. I will. So these are better than cards. I prefer stuff like this, so there's no confusion, or I don't have to worry about selling something or yada, yada, yada. But I don't know. I guess I digress. Coming from a set hunter standpoint, in order to obtain a card you need for a set, if you feel like you need to sell or trade or do something with a card I sent you, by all means, do it. Some of you might agree with that. Some of you might not. I'm just kind of throwing in a little bit of different perspective for you. But it's the thought that counts. I mean, I still have the majority of the cards people have sent me. But, I mean, hey, I'm letting you know if I ever sent you something and the last thing I want you to do is feel guilt about keeping it. You know, the only reason why that card is still in your collection is because it was a gift and you've passed up other cards that were better than the one I sent you just because you would feel guilty. You don't need to feel guilty at all, okay? Anyway. Who would have thought? How's this for irony? The Broncos fan holding up a Seahawks helmet. Only on BBF21's channel will you ever find irony that delicious. Have a good night. Stay warm. See you next season, Broncos, huh?